All right, the time's now 9:39. That morning cup or two of coffee may come with more than just a caffeine fix. New research reveals that morning joe can actually be good for you. Yes, you heard that right. And so here to talk about those benefits and much more, we are live with Dr. Aleksander Jankov, an oncologist at the Baptist Cancer Center here in Memphis. Doctor, I know you are busy, so we appreciate you being with us this morning. Okay, so many may be surprised by this, by what I just said, that coffee can actually be good for you. How?
Yes, thank you, Simone. I'm glad to be with you this morning. So for years, we wondered, how should we feel about our coffee? Is coffee drinking our guilty pleasure, or it's actually good for us? And decades of research have been done, and we have some answers. You know, we knew early on that green coffee bean is full of healthy bioactive compounds, polyphenols, antioxidants, anti-inflammatory substances, and cancer-fighting properties. But, you know, the concern has always been what happens during roasting process, converting a green coffee bean to a brown coffee bean, and then subsequently, when brewing coffee, are there any, unwanted compounds present? And I'm happy to report that after several decades of research, coffee has been largely exonerated of these concerns. Not only that's actually our favorite pick-me-up drink, and but it's also very healthy for us. So in general, but to be more specific, I'll start from head to toe, so to speak. It's good for our brain health. It reduces the chances of the stroke for people drinking four cups a day. It cuts down on risk of Parkinson's disease, helps with our cognitive function. Also, it reduces the chances of type 2 diabetes. It helps with insulin sensitivity. It also helps reduce the chance of breast cancer in postmenopausal women. It's very, very good for our liver. It's great for liver. It fights the inflammation in the liver, reduces the chances of developing fatty liver disease and progression to liver cirrhosis and later on to liver cancer. It's been also shown to be great for colon cancer. It prevents occurrence of the colon cancer. It delays the progression of the colon cancer in later stages. It cuts down on the chances of developing endometrial cancer. And amazingly, it's also good for prostate in men. It cuts down on chances of developing prostate cancer, especially the higher grade prostate cancer. So in conclusion, I would say, don't ever feel guilty about drinking your coffee. Just enjoy it.
Oh, doctor, that's really interesting. And I know there are people who probably think they drink an excessive amount of coffee. So is there a thing of, you know, is there too much? Can you drink too much?
You would want to be careful about more than 400 milligrams of caffeine per day, which is roughly 4 cups. But that depends on how you like your coffee roasted. So lighter roast has more caffeine. Darker roasting surprisingly has less caffeine. But I like to put this in perspective. Americans use 9 pounds of coffee per person per year, while Finland is the absolute world record holder, and the average person goes through 26 pounds of coffee per person per year. So I would say stick with 4 cups of coffee, or if you want to be accurate, check your roast and figure out how much is 400 milligrams of caffeine per day.
Okay. And in your line of work, doctor, I know you deal with a lot of cancer patients. Do you see coffee as a concern in any of your patients?
I wouldn't think it's a concern. As I mentioned, after all the research, one concern that existed before, there was concern, but it's hard to tease out the coffee from all other habits that we have. So, for example, there was a concern about bladder cancer years ago, but it turns out that people who drink coffee also like to smoke, or actually smokers like to drink coffee. So that was kind of largely ruled out. And I would recommend people drinking coffee, everything in moderation, however, but it's good for us. And it's a basically seed of the fruit. So it's a good nutritious drink.
All right, doctor, we have a lot of coffee drinkers up with us bright and early, so I'm sure they just learned a lot from all you just said. Thank you so much for being with us this morning. That information is right there on your screen. All right, we still have a lot to get to this morning. We'll be right back. Stay with us.